Hey everybody, welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board certified OBGYN. And today we're talking about, can you actually feel fibroids moving in your stomach? In this video, we'll be looking at a variety of things, including fibroids and their growth inside of your uterus, risk factors for fibroids, symptoms of fibroids, as well as can you feel them moving inside of your stomach? So let's dive into it today. So what are fibroids? Fibroids are smooth muscle tumors, which may grow anywhere inside of your uterus. And a majority of them are benign, meaning that they're not cancerous. They're actually quite common. Research has shown that up to 70% of females may have fibroids at some point during their reproductive years, known or unknown, which if you ask me is quite common. These growths may happen in any layer of the uterus. What does that mean? Well, I'll show you right here. Inside of the uterus, which is this structure right here, we have three different layers. This inside area here, this is the endometrial cavity. It's the inner layer. It's the area where bleeding comes from. It's the area that gives life to a growing child. Now, if there's a fibroid in that space, you may have symptoms of having heavy vaginal bleeding. This could be on your menstrual cycle or your period. This could be bleeding in between your periods. This could be postmenopausal bleeding. Either way, this is bleeding that is not warranted and really should not be happening. Fibroids in that area may also lead to anemia, as well as hemorrhaging, potentially even leading to the need for a blood transfusion. So these fibroids in this space are actually quite dangerous. The next area where fibroids may develop is right here in the muscular layer of the uterus. These are called intramural fibroids. These can be problematic if they get really large, but more so, they are just there silently sitting in this space, not really causing too much of a problem. Fibroids may also live on the outer skin or serosa of the uterus. In this space here, they are called subserosal fibroids. These fibroids really are just entertaining your abdomen, your uterus, your pelvis, and they're really not causing you much of any problems. At most, I would say, they may just cause you to have like a bigger abdomen, depending on how many you have or how large your uterus is. They can be a little bit filling. They can cause you to feel bloated. They can cause your abdominal space to be firmer or bigger than what it normally would be. Fibroids can also do one more thing. They can actually grow a stalk off of the uterus and hang anywhere inside of your pelvis, literally like a fruit hanging off of a tree. And so with that, those fibroids also may not cause you any real pain or problems, but they may fill your abdominal cavity, and sometimes they can grow so big that they may be the size of like a melon. Fibroids can be quite large, and they can be as small as a grain of rice. Regardless of the size, the location of these fibroids truly matters. As I mentioned earlier, within the internal space, these fibroids are dangerous. In all other layers of the uterus, those fibroids may remain there for years, if not decades, as long as they're not continuing to grow rapidly, and as long as we do not consider them to be dangerous as far as being potentially malignant or cancerous. Now, how do we know that? We examine different properties of fibroids to determine whether or not they're cancerous, how they look on imaging, how quickly they grow, and if they exhibit anything that's unusual, meaning they change forms and they're developing in a way that's just not typical. In general, normal fibroids would grow at a rate of about 1 centimeter to maybe 2 centimeters per year. Once fibroids are developing much faster than that, then we consider and may want to remove them regardless of the size because of how fast they're growing. So what are some risk factors for developing fibroids? One being female and hormonal is a huge part of it, but having a history, a family history of fibroids increases the likelihood that you'll have fibroids as well. Obesity is another risk factor. Having a diet high in red meat. And we're still researching and investigating what truly is the link with red meat. There are quite a lot of other risk factors as well. And so it is very important that if you are at risk or if you have fibroids, that you investigate a little bit deeper and kind of check off the boxes for all the different risk factors that you may have and how you can potentially change your lifestyle to be able to decrease the likelihood of them increasing in number, growing pretty quickly or very largely, or becoming problematic for you. So can you feel fibroids moving inside of your stomach? Just to medically use the correct terms here, instead of saying your stomach, which is your GI tract, we're going to say in your abdomen, the space on the inside where your organs are living and where fibroids would reside as well. And so the simple answer is potentially. You may very well feel fibroids moving in your abdomen. It all depends on the type of fibroid that you have. So if you have a pedunculated fibroid, which is the one that can hang off with a stalk, that fibroid can literally move around your abdominal space as you move and live your best life. So if you're running, you may feel this fibroid essentially going up and down inside of your abdomen. If you lay from side to side, you may feel the movement of this mass, especially if it's large enough, switching from side to side with you. If you're standing, you may feel more pressures on your bladder or even on your rectum as well, depending on where it's located. So yes, you may be able to differentiate or to perceive the movement of this fibroid. Now, in general, if you're staying still, fibroids do not move on their own. They don't have some internal power to just switch positions. It's really just based on gravity and is specific only to those fibroids that are pedunculated. All other fibroids within the uterus really should not be able to move much outside of the movement of your uterus. And your uterus really has its structure tucked into your pelvis that you should not feel movement at all. Sometimes you may have like a GI problem where your colon may be moving and causing symptoms that you may be aware of. That if you do have a history of fibroids, that you may think is the same thing as, you know, fibroids moving, but really they're completely separate things. If you have fibroids and you're really curious about what's happening internally, really have a detailed conversation with your provider so that you understand where your fibroids are located. Watch this video again if you needed to, and to know how they are positioned and how they move, their size, and how they're growing. These are all really important information. So I really hope that you've understood everything we've talked about so far. And listen, I have a wonderful gift for you today. Since we're talking about hormones and what's happening with our systems and different conditions that may develop because of hormone changes, I'd like to offer you a free copy of my ebook, Hormones Don't Lie. And you can get that copy today by clicking the link below this video and just follow the prompts. I'd be so happy to share that with you. Lots of good knowledge to be gained by reading this book. Thank you. Thank you for entertaining this video today. Thank you for being a part of this channel and for sharing and liking and subscribing as well. Please do so if you haven't. But it's really a pleasure to share this information with you. And if you have a question, please drop it in the comment below. If not, I hope you'll hang around and join us on the next video. Take care.